My name is Susan Tome, and I am a physical therapy assistant major at Penn State Mont Alto.
I'm Betty McConkey, and my husband, Bob, and I have been living here at Quincy for 11 and a half years.
My name is Chris Miller, and I'm a PTA major.
My name is Bob McConkey. We moved here from Gettysburg.
My name is Autumn Adler, and my major is physical therapy assistant.
Well, my name is Ruthie Good, and we actually started to move here in November.
My name is Caitlin Myers, and I'm a physical therapy assistant student.
Well, my name is Joe Herring, and I have lived here 2 years. And I love this place, just love it, and I love the gardening.
In the summer of 2011, faculty from Penn State University's Mont Alto campus designed an educational experience that would allow students of the college to interact with residents of a local retirement community.
It is a different project because we have included three major disciplines on the campus, and there are three disciplines that really, to my knowledge, never really worked together before on other types of projects, but because we have a good forestry program here, they're very good at working with the wood and the carpentry type things and knowing about soil and planting, and they offer that. The OT students have been very helpful in looking at adaptive equipment, adaptive gardening tools, and just kind of use of space. And the physical therapy students are helping with deciding how high the raised bed should be, looking at the different disabilities that the residents come with. We've had patients or residents with total hip replacements, total knee replacements, arthritic conditions, degenerative neurological diseases, all kinds of different things, and the PTA students probably have the most knowledge of those areas.
In September and October, faculty and students visited the Quincy Village Retirement Facility to assess the needs of residents.
Right. I think we want like the 22-inch height for the wheelchair, and then a little higher.
You need the measurements
for the stand.
Right down through. Okay.
By January of 2012, plans were underway to design and build two raised gardens, which would enable residents who could no longer work at ground level to continue their passion for gardening.
The residents talked a lot about how difficult it is just to get to the level of the ground if the garden isn't raised, and how, you know, it hurts if they have arthritis or if they have trouble just breathing when they're in a crouched position, or getting up from there can be a real problem. So having the beds up where they're not leaning, or they're just not having to exert as much effort, I think that will help them out a lot.
I know of several people that have given up the garden, and I just talked to one that he said, and this is a good example, he said, I'm really going to miss my garden. I said, John, we have raised gardens coming in. So he's one of my men that I'm looking forward to having him work in the raised gardens. And then we have another gentleman that is in a wheelchair, and I'm looking, I think he's going to be interested in, I know his wife has a plot down here, so I'm sure he'll be coming to our new facility.
Up there, all we know is 4 feet wide.
4 feet wide.
4 feet 560.
And
that helps you. Make an acre.
I'm not buying.
So
that's not
we
buying.
Will gather with our students and get a plan and go to Lowe's and Home Depot and start to price stuff out.
It wasn't until this year I
set some dates to build, and then we'll be back.
So.
Plans were finalized. In February, construction began.
Live with each other.
everybody busy and everybody enjoying and engaged and thinking about what the overall purpose is here and hopefully the end product. Obviously, this is a real community effort.
In April, occupational therapy students returned to Quincy Village, where they put together pots of plants useful in making pizza, tomato plants, basil plants, pepper plants. These pizza pots provided an alternative gardening opportunity for residents who were less inclined to use the raised gardens. Then in May, residents returned to the raised gardens to begin planting.
I think we've all been impressed by how happy this group of people is. They take their gardening very seriously. A lot of these people are master gardeners and have gardened throughout their whole lives and know a whole lot more about gardening than we do. So we're learning from them as well.
The seeds that had been planted quickly flourished.
The Service Learning Project is basically over now. Although I've heard from the residents at Quincy, those members of the gardening club have asked for another 12-foot raised bed garden because this one's gone over so well. They've actually increased numbers of members in the gardening club, which was a real surprise and actually a very nice thing. And partly because of the raised beds, it's given a lot of the residents the opportunity to garden, those people who wouldn't have had the opportunity before. From the student standpoint, I'd say it's also been quite a success. I had the students do a reflection paper at the end of the experience, and the outcomes were wonderful. As far as what they thought they got out of the project, virtually all the students said they were worried about the time commitment when they started, and they weren't thinking they were going to just love it, but by the end they did really enjoy it. They found it a very valuable experience. And another thing that really made me happy was hearing that they all said they thought it was something they would continue throughout life because of this experience, that they found that they felt so good about what they did and they enjoyed the experience working with people and doing something kind of novel and different with them, that they would seek out other volunteer community engagement type experiences throughout their life. And that really was one of the goals, was to kind of foster that feeling.
That way I don't have to come
The things that I like about working with the elderly population is mostly the interactions that I have with them are very meaningful. They often are easier to develop to...